Welcome to Everything Computerized, I'm CA, and in this video I'll be going to explain the transaction control language and the three commands present in it. So watch this video till end and let's get started. Save this playlist basic SQL tutorial for class 10 and 12 so that you do not miss out any video that might be important for you. In the previous video, I had explained the data control language. Let's now talk about the transaction control language and the three commands present in it. So what is transaction control language? When we perform operations on a table with the help of the data manipulation language, that is, if we insert a data into a table, if we delete a data from a table, or if we update a data from the table, these all operations are not permanent, and the changes which happen to the table are temporary, and the table which is present on the actual server has not been affected at all. So in order to apply these changes to the table permanently, we have to do something, and so we make use of the TCL commands. So basically TCL helps us to control the transactions in a table. Here transaction means any process or operation which we perform on a table with the help of DML commands. Use of insert command is also a transaction, use of delete command is also a transaction, and use of update command is also a transaction. So TCL helps us to control how we operate on a table, that is, the transactions in a table. I think you are quite clear with the concept of the transaction control language. Let's now take a look at its definition. Transaction control language, or TCL, is a computer programming language, basically a component of SQL, which is used to manage transactions in a database. This is used to manage changes made to the data in a table by DML statements. It also allows statements to be grouped together into logical transactions. There are three commands present in TCL. These are commit, rollback, and SavePoint. Let's understand what these commands are, and after that I'll show you how these work in MySQL. So the first command we are going to talk about is the commit command. It is used to save the changes made to the table and hence making the changes permanent. When we use this command, the changes that we had made to the table is uploaded to the server, and hence our work is saved. The next command is the rollback command. It is used to get back to the previous permanent status of the table. That is, if I started editing a table and I thought that the changes that I have made is not required, I can roll back or get back to the previous permanent status of the table. One thing that you have to note about the rollback command is that if you committed your changes, you cannot roll back. You can roll back only if the changes made are temporary, and the table can be rolled back to its last permanent change. Let's now talk about the last command of TCL, that is the SavePoint command. It is used along with the rollback command. It is a command in TCL which is used to mark a transaction in a table. Suppose you are making a very long table and you want to roll back only to a certain position in a table, then this can be achieved using the SavePoint command. If you made a transaction in a table, you can mark that transaction as a certain name, and later on if you want to roll back to that point, you can do it easily by using the transaction's name. SavePoint is helpful when we want to roll back only a small part of the table and not the whole table. In simple words, you can say that SavePoint is a bookmark in SQL. Now that you have understood the basics of the TCL commands, let's see how these work in MySQL. In MySQL, there is a setting named AutoCommit. It is enabled by default, and every command we write is automatically committed and the changes are permanent. So the TCL command does not make any sense to it. You can try it yourself and check if the TCL commands work on it or not. For the TCL commands to run on MySQL, either you have to turn off the auto commit or you have to write a statement start transaction. So we will use the start transaction statement. Run the MySQL command line client and write start transaction. It will disable the auto commit till you close this window. So whatever you do now will be temporary and will not affect the SQL server until you manually commit it. So I have inserted some rows into a table. Let's close the MySQL window and check if the changes are applied to the table or not in a new SQL window. So you can see that the transaction that I had made before has not been applied to the table, and the rows have not been inserted. Let's repeat the same thing, but this time I'll use the commit command. So let's close this window and open a new one and check if the changes were made or not. So you can see that this time the rows have been inserted. Let's use the rollback command. So I have written the commands to update, insert and delete a row. Let's see the table now. Here you have to note that I have not committed, so the changes that I am doing now are temporary and the table which is on the server has not been affected and is of this format. And this one is the temporary table. Let's now run the rollback command. So you can see that the table has been rolled back to the previous committed state and the transactions, that is the changes that I had made using these three DML statements, are discarded. Let's run the exact three DML statements, but this time I'll use the commit command before rollback. So I have committed the transactions. Let's run the rollback command. So you can see that the rollback command did not work. This is because we have made the transactions permanent with the commit command. Let's now see how we can roll back to a specific position in a table with SavePoint. Let's name the current position as initial. Now I'll run the insert command and name this transaction as INS. After this the update command and name as UPD. And at last the delete command and name as DEL. You can take any name of your choice. I have taken these names because it will be easier to refer. Let's see the table. So this is the temporary table. I don't want to execute the delete command, so I will roll back to UPD. It will discard all the transactions after UPD and the transactions before UPD are not affected. So this is how the TCL commands work. You can experiment on it by running different statements and explore the different outputs. But one thing that you have to remember, that in MySQL, first you have to execute the start transaction command before running TCL commands or else it will not work. So this was all about the transaction control language. In the next video, I'll explain the detailed concept of the select statement. So meanwhile, like this video and subscribe the channel if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.